الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعوا بالإحسان لمدين إخوة الفاضل. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. After we started reciting Surah Al-Najm from verse 33, we stopped at ayah 48, right? Okay, we start at ayah 48. Okay, I would rather make us to start, inshallah, prefer us to start at ayah 42, please. Ayah 42. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said from ayah 42, he said, وَأَنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ لُمُنْتَهَى. This is Surah Al-Najm, chapter 53. We started, now we are starting from verse 42. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ أَلْمُنْتَهَى. Indeed, to your Lord is the final place of abode. How long the person lives, I live, however time, or whatever time, I mean, you spend in this world, that time will definitely come to an end one day, sooner or later. So to your Lord is the final place of abode. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَضْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى. And it is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who grants laughter, make people laugh, give them fortune, good news. And it is He, Allah, who make some they cry. As I said today, some are crying because of pain, physically, they are feeling, or maybe because of something dearest to them they've lost. And one or some are laughing, smiling, celebrating because of good news, or the health or fortunes that they've received. It is He, Allah, who grants laughter and tears. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَى. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who grants life and death. How many people, they fell off? How many stories, but they did not die? Because the life is still there. The time has not due for them to depart this world yet. And it is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also who grants life. He grants death and life. وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوَجَيْنِ. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who creates the pairs. الذَّكَرُ وَالْأُنْثَى. Male as well as female. Allah created us in pairs. It is He, Allah, who did that. مِن نُطْفَةٍ إِذَا تُمْنَى. Allah created us from a semen, a fluid that has no worth. But from that sperm, Allah make all of us walking on the surface of this earth, we can talk, see, and have all these faculties. وَأَنَّ عَلَيْهِ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُخْرَى. And it is He, Allah, who will indeed promise a second creation again, bring us back to life after death. Imagine, when one dies, they become dust, rotting. But Allah recreates you and myself again to bring us to account. It is He, Allah, only Allah, who can do that. وَأَنَّهُ. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as well, who أَغْنَى وَأَقْنَى. It is He, Allah, who give it or give wealth. Not because you are knowledgeable, you are skillful, that brings you wealth. No, this is just a means. But Allah is the one who grants you or grants wealth and satisfaction. Contentment. May Allah give us contentment and satisfaction, Ya Kareem. وَأَنَّهُ. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are رَبُّ شِعْرَى. It is here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of Sirius. The Lord of Sirius is a star, a mighty star. The Lord of that star. And the Sheikh will explain it to you. وَأَنَّهُ It is here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also أَهْلَكَ عَادًا الْأُولَى He destroyed the powerful ancient Ad, the people of Ad. And that is the people of Prophet Hud. They were mighty in power, they're strong, but Allah destroyed them. وَثَمُودَ فَمَا أَبَقَى And the Thamud, the people of Salih alayhi salam, he left no trace of them, Allah said, when I destroyed them. وَقَوْمَ نُوحٍ مِّن قَبْلٍ And the people of Nuh alayhi salam, Allah destroyed them before. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا هُمْ أَذْلَمَ وَأَطْغَى They were people of injustice, they were unjust. And also as well, they transgress. وَالْمُؤْتَفِكَةَ الْأَهْوَى وَالْمُؤْتَفِكَةَ أَهْوَى And he destroyed the overthrown cities, the city of Sodom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed him. Gomara, isn't it? فَغَشَّاهَا مَا غَشَّاهَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covered it with whatever he covered. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكَ تَتَمَارَى Then tell me, which of the favors of your Lord, O humankind, O you human being, will you dispute about? Allah can destroy anyone. Allah blessed some people and they did not take it for granted. They did not worship Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring their power, their fortune, their happiness down. May Allah save us from His punishment, Ya Kareem. Allah said all this, هَذَا نَذِيرٌ It is a warning, a warner to you and myself, مِنَ النُّذْرِ الْأُولَى Of the series of wonders that has passed, Azifatil Azifa, the hour, the day of judgment, or the time of fitna, destruction, for this world to come to an end, it's approaching, brothers and sisters. It is approaching, Allah is telling you, Azifatil Azifa, it has approached or approaching. Sunnah, Laysa laha min dunillahi kashifa. No one but Allah can disclose it to me and you. May Allah save us from His torment, His punishment, Ya Kareem. After min hadha al-hadith, ta'ajabun. After you've had all these words, brothers and sisters, all you, the Muslims, you've had all these statements, all these admonitions. Allah said if you had about them, but yet still, you are just there. Not pondering, but rather taking it for granted. You're taking this for granted. What the hakun? You laugh. You celebrate every day. You rejoice. Celebrating birthdays, celebrating parties, celebrating here, as if you've achieved al-jannah. But rather, Allah said, What the hakun? You are just full with laughter. Wala tabkun. You don't cry. You don't weep. This is something that should make one ponder over them again and again, contemplate and then cry. Because what is awaiting for me and you is greater than what you think. وَأَنْتُمْ سَامِدُونَ And wasting your time with this vanity world. Subhanallah. After all this, we are celebrating and we are not crying, we are not weeping. And then we are running after this world, after these vanities. Allah said, now that you've heard this, it's time for you to turn to Allah. What should you do? First, judu lillah. Prostrate down to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prostrate to Him. Submit yourself to Him. Wa'budu. And worship Allah alone. Adore yourself and your worship only to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the servants who will adore themselves and devote themselves to the will and command of Allah. May the brothers and sisters, with the permission of the Shaykh, have recited the ayat and tell you the nutshell meaning of them. Without much ado, I'll pass the mic now to the Shaykh to tell us lessons learned. فَلْيَتَفَضَّلِ الشَّيْخِ مَشْكُورٌ
بارك الله فيك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد. Well, brothers and sisters, continue from where we reached. When you come to Ayah 33, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us regarding the person who turned away when the message came to him. And he said that I'm going to give more and so forth. Afterwards he said, oh, I'm tired now, I cannot do it again. And who was that? He was the father of Khalid bin Walid. So what was his name? That man, he was the father of Khalid bin Walid. So what was his name? You don't know his name? I said he was the father of Khalid bin Walid.
Walid.
So Walid bin Mughira, he was the one who was doing this to him. And look at what his son became. One of the warriors in Islam. But he was in the opposite side. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ الْغَيْبِ. Does he have any kind of unseen knowledge regarding what he was saying about? That I gave and so forth until I put this one here. But at the end of the day, they don't have knowledge of what is going to happen the next day. Now, Allah asked us regarding this particular person. Didn't he been informed about what was being written in the books before? Because they used to be going to the Jewish people and the Christians to ask some, you know, things so that they can get a proof against Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But any time that they went, it turned against them. In other words, whatever thing they went for, at the end of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed unto Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and gave answers to it. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the book of Musa alayhi salam and also in the book of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Book of Ibrahim alayhi salam. You all know about it. What was in the book of Ibrahim alayhi salam? For example, when you go to Surah 16, Ayah 120 to 123. Surah 16, Ayah 120 to 123. You know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said regarding Ibrahim alayhi salam. 120 to 123. Ayah. You find it? Surah 16. Have you found Surah 16 in the first place?
Yes.
Okay.
Just find it.
Yeah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وآتيناه في الدنيا حسنة وإنه في الآخرة لمن الصالحين. And we have given Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام good food.
120.
Surah 16, 120. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا ولم يكن من المشركين. Did you finally see this?
Yes.
إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا ولم يكن من المشركين. إبراهيم, verily, إبراهيم عليه الصلاة والسلام was an ummah, a leader of the nation. That is, he has all the good righteous qualities Allah has given him as a nation, a father of a nation. He is obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does not worship false God. He worshiped none but Allah. And he was not one of those who were al-mushrikeen, those who are polytheists, who worship idols. He worshiped Allah alone. He did not join partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Oh, I go back in here. Sorry, my Sheikh. Sorry, I apologize on behalf of my Sheikh. And, all right, 120, right? To
123.
Okay, 23. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا ولم يك من المشركين شاكرا لأنعمه اجتباه وهداه إلى صراط مستقيم وآتيناه في الدنيا حسنة وإنه في الآخرة لمن الصالحين. الله says إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله.
Up to
124. Yeah. Oh, okay. Subhanallah. ثم أوحينا إليك أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين. Allah says, إن إبراهيم كان أمة قانتا لله حنيفا. As the Sheikh said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said here that Ibrahim was indeed a model and devotedly or devoutly obedient to Allah. He was an obedient servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a man of true faith, a man of tawheed. وَلَمْ يَكُ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. He did not join Allah with a partner. One was a man of tawheed. And that's why he was called Ummah, a nation, subhanAllah. شَاكِرًا لِأَنُعُمِ. He was very grateful for the favors of Allah upon him. Gratitude. He was a grateful man. He showed gratitude to Allah. He showed his gratitude for the favor of Allah. اجتباه وهداه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him and guided him إلى صراط مستقيم, to the straight path. And Allah said, وآتيناه في الدنيا حسنة. Allah gave him good in this world. وإنه في الآخرة. And in the hereafter, he will be lamina. Sorry, he will be lamina solihin. Yeah. He will be amongst the righteous ones in the higher rank. Yawm al qiyamah. Oh, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us high rank in al jannah ya kareem.
Amen.
ثم أوحينا إليك. And then we revealed unto you, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and all of you here. أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا. For you to go along the path, you follow the way, the teachings, the lifestyle of Ibrahim عليه السلام, the one who Allah has blessed with true faith. وما كان من المشركين. He never joined Allah with partners. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the people who follow the true teachings of Abraham, Ibrahim alayhi salam, and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had told us why Ibrahim alayhi salam, his name has emerged. He has been given the book also, and you are going to hear what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said regarding the books that were given, the book that was given to Ibrahim alayhi salam. What was the name of the book that was given to Ibrahim alayhi salam?
Suhuf. Okay. Suhuf of Ibrahim. The Suhuf of Ibrahim.
Suhuf of Ibrahim. Suhuf of Ibrahim. Okay, that means the scrolls and so forth that Allah has given to him. But Allah has chosen 14 main aspects of that for us from that book. What are those 14 extracts that Allah chose from that book or from that scrolls to tell us? Yes. 14.
14 main aspects
that Allah has chosen, extracted from that scrolls that was given to Ibrahim alayhi salam.
Thou shalt not kill. Okay, I like you go straight to the commandment. I like that. Now, al-Hajj. Okay, the Sheikh said al-Hajj. We should not associate partners with Allah. Okay. No.
Fasting.
Yes. Mashallah. Did he used to fast like Ramadan? Okay.
Alright, make it easy for them. Start from verse 38 of the same Surah Al-Najm.
Okay, we start from verse 38 here. Surah Al-Najm.
So you know this 14, how important it is to Allah.
The same Surah.
The same Surah, Surah Al-Najm 53. Surah 53. A tricky way.
That's a very good trick. 14. Allah extracted them from the Suhuf, the scroll of Musa alayhi salam. Oh yeah. Okay. So.
You have seen it? Go ahead.
Each man will carry his own burden.
Okay. Each man will carry his own burden. Yeah.
Man will only get what he strives for.
In other words, you will earn what you work for. You will be rewarded according to your deeds. Returning to your God is the final abode.
It's about the brothers.
Sorry, come to be not you after.
You have seen it?
Okay, the brothers. What about the brothers?
They shall return to the return is over.
You know, when the sisters here, they listen to these lectures, when he's being circulated, they will say, Mashallah, the sisters are more hard working than the brothers. We want our machine to be active with the brothers too. Inshallah. Yes?
Well,
on the birthdays.
All of us shall go back to the Lord.
Everyone, we go back to the Lord. Allah,
I think there is a sign wherein it says something like, his heart will not swallow them.
Okay, no, with that school, with these ones, you can see these ones here, from here. Which one do you choose from here? That's chapter 53. Yeah, from verse 38 down onwards.
Surah 53.
Yeah, Surah 53.
His sisters are following now.
I know.
Brothers are not following.
Yes, go on.
Okay, go on. Now you said, so Allah is the final place of abode. But you jumped. Okay, let me keep quiet. Okay, because you were saying it. I shouldn't want. Didn't you jump a few ones? You jumped. Did you jump over the fence? Okay.
But
is
he counting how many?
14.
Yeah.
Are you
counting?
Yeah.
So let me just make an example here. Yes. Go on. Alright. No,
continue. Okay. Oh, okay. Sheikh said I should give it to you. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm going to read the ayat, yeah? Just the meaning now. Do I have to read again?
Read the meaning.
Good, thank you. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَّا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةُ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. Indeed, no one will bear the burden of another soul, right? وَأَنْ لَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. One will not achieve or earn except what they strive for. وَأَنَّ سَعْيَهُ سُوفَ يُرَى. They will see the results of what they strive for. ثُمَّ يُجْزَاهُ الْجَزَاءُ الْأَوْفَى جَزَاءَ الْأَوْفَى. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them with a complete reward. وَأَنَّ إِلَى رَبِّكَ الْمُنْتَهَى. To your Lord is the final place of abode. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَدْحَكَ وَأَبَكَ. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who grants laughter and tears. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَى. And it is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who grants life and death. Right? وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ إِذَا تُمْنَى. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created man and female as pairs from a semen, a drug, a spice semen. وَأَنَّ عَلَيْهِ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُخْرَى. And so He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will be the one that will bring us again to another creation, recreating man again. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَغْنَى وَأَقْنَى. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who grants wealth and satisfaction, right? وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ رَبُّ الشِّعْرَى. The Lord of the mighty star. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَهْلَكَ عَادٍ.
Especially back home.
I know.
Yeah. That kind of star. Mm. It is a bluish color. It is very, very bright.
Okay. The Cyrus, yeah? I call it Cyrus. The Cyrus star. The mighty one, yeah? Now, the Sheikh said you see it in the village, all of you. You went to your village. Have you visited your village? Visit your village? May I visit my village, you know, Kerry Town? But then the kind of punishment. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكَ تَتَمَارَى. Which of the favors of your Lord, O humankind, that you will dispute about? This is a warner from the previous warners that has passed. And the hour is closer, coming closer and closer. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in summary, that it's time for us to admonish ourselves, reflect, and prostrate to your Allah, to Allah, devote yourself to Allah in worship or with worship. Now you've known them, right? Good. So these are the matters or aspects Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extracts from the book of Moses that we have as well in the Ibrahim alayhi salam that we have as well in the any words? From the Quran. We have it in the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from all of us. Yeah, now we're going to take question and answer just one, two, khalas, and then 9:15. So then we have our meal and eat, because Sheikh Bali wants to eat cassava leaf. He is used to cassava leaf from Sierra Leone. We eat before. Inshallah. Okay, anyone? Any question? Yes, straight.
When Allah subhanahu said that he covered these people, these people.
What he covered them with?
Yes, what he covered them. Is it water and is it nearer Israel somewhere, you know, in the side of Israel?
We'll come into that next week, inshallah. We'll come into that, you will know what covered them, inshallah. Yeah.
One question.
Yes, my Sheikh.
With regards to the Muazzin, before you came,
Sheikh was saying, yeah.
Like I remember one time I was doing my salah.
No.
So I didn't realize that the adhan is going to be called. So I was praying. Mm-hmm. So when he said that just now, I was thinking, oh, maybe I might have stopped or I still continue my prayer.
Okay. So now the brother wants to know regarding Muazzin. If one is praying, then Muazzin is doing the adhan. Immediately when they start Allahu Akbar, then Muazzin do the adhan. Should they stop their prayer and then listen until the Muazzin finish, make their dua, make whatever, when they finish, then start praying again? Or they should continue praying?
Well, if the person is in state of salah, then you continue your salah. But if I have not yet started your salah, then you have to stop and wait until the Muazzin finishes. And when he finished, and you make the dua, and as the Prophet had said, and you add this one to it, Radhiyatu billahi rabba, wa bil islami deena, wa bi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nabiyyan wa rasoola. He said, if you say this and put it, your sins will be forgiven. Inshallah ta'ala.
Allahumma anta salam, wa minka salam, ilayka salam, wa ilayka yarju salam, tabarak badal jalal al-ikram, rabbana dhalamna anfusana, wa inna taghfir lana, wa tarhamna, anna kunna minal khasirin, rabbana atina fid dunya hasanatan, wa fil akhirati hasanatan, wa qina adhabana, rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana, وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ سُبْحَانَ رَبِّكَ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَى الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ